The shortstop, Jeremy Peña.
The pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. Muziati is there. One pitch, one out. Time now to check out how the hometown Dodgers line up in this one. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, Matt, I think the cleanup hitter might be the difference in this game. He's coming off a game in which he had four hits, including a home run. I saw him during batting practice. He was smiling and he was feeling good about himself. The confidence was just oozing out of him.
So, fellas, this Indians ball club, as they begin play here this afternoon, they come in playing well. 6-3 over the last nine ball games, including a victory last time out.
Yeah, Matty, I can't tell you how important it is to throw that first run up on the board, and that's exactly what they did. A little crooked number, a two spot, to give their pitcher a chance to relax and go out and pound the strike zone. This team has been playing red-hot baseball recently.
A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Here you go, guys. Let's go.
And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. One out, nobody on. Got him.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Batting third.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. As he'll watch a knuckleball that finds the zone for strike one. 276, the average coming in for him. 27 homers and 64 runs batted in. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Yanked fouled off to the right.
Hey, here we go. Nope.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
One ball, two strikes to count.
Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Two out, nobody on. Not close with the knuckleball that time.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grind.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. I think a few of these folks need to get out of the sun. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. So stepping in, Michael Lemon, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Oh, and now look at this. The pitcher gives one a ride to deep left. And it's gone. And good for him. Michael Lemon has just launched his first major league home run. Hard to say how many more of these he'll hit in his career, but for now, I'm sure he's happy to say he's got at least one.
Well, I think that any kid who's ever dreamed about playing this game dreams exactly this. Watching the ball disappear over the fence, then circling the bases in a big league ballpark. He'll be replaying that at bat over and over in his head. And now his phone's gonna blow up. He'll be calling his parents, his buddies. Everybody's going to be talking about this one.
And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Michael Brasso. And he's a guy really in need of something to click at the plate right now. It's been a rough go for him.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
One ball, no strikes to count.
Plays it first here.
Line drive to left. There to make the play is Calhoun, one away.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Striding into the box, Will Smith. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night.
Now he bounces a knuckleball up to the plate for a ball. Bases are empty, one man out.
That evens it up, 1-1.
One down, one down.
Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Hey, all right, here we go now.
Hits this one hard the other way. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Batting fifth, the right fielder.
So now to the plate, Lazaro Armenteros, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He comes in still down on the interstate at 199. Two home runs and 17 RBIs. Has a look, now the pitch.
Ball one.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
The 1-2 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike three.
Made pretty quick work of him right there, setting him down on only four pitches. And what I liked about all of those pitches, what they were down around the knees or lower. Pretty hard to do any kind of damage when pitches are located in that spot.
Batting seven, the second baseman, Drew Jackson.
Hey, get ahead, stay ahead, right now.
In now, Drew Jackson. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. The numbers offensively pretty dismal to this point, down in the 170s to start play. Five homers and 11 RBIs. Working for the punch out and the offering. Swing and there it goes. He got all of that ball and off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field. So a two-run shot to left center. Sixth home run on the season for him. And the Dodgers are back within a run at 3-2 now.
Hey, every once in a while, this speed guy will jump up and bite one. He absolutely crushed that baseball. Doesn't fit his usual tool description, but he can go deep if you leave one over the heart of the plate.
Hey, come on, guys.
Into the box now, Clyde Reynolds. as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He'll enter play here with an average just over 250, four home runs and 15 RBIs.
Hey, now we've got two.
Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Aye.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. So it's two runs here on two hits, with one of them being the home run. Ready now, Michael Lemon, and their runners at the corners now.
And in that last at bat, it makes you think this guy might have went up there looking for the breaking ball, because he certainly got a breaking ball, and he didn't miss it. Hit it right on the screws.
Reynolds is there. He's got it, and there are two down now. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Dennis Santana.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Jeremy Pena
will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. One and one to the Dodgers leadoff man. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
Everything this guy throws moves, and that two-seamer has a mind of its own.
Vierling is back in. Plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone. Digging in for his second at bat, Drew Avens. Nope. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Hey, the knuckleball giggling at him as it goes by. One and one. Right there at the belt. One and two now.
The count is one and two.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder giving chase. He can't get there in time, and now it hops over the wall for a ground rule double.
Cody Bellinger
is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball that's 1-0. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So striding forward now, Michael Brasso. He starts the inning, and Dan, they're down six in the early going, so what do they need to do to claw back into this thing?
Well, first of all, Matt, I think they need to start to get some base runners. It's hard to be patient when you're down by six, but base runners are the key to getting back into this one.
Fielded cleanly, throws in time, and that's out number one. Now to the plate, Will Smith. He singled his last time up. Knuckleball below the knees, 1-0. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Made him look silly with that one.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
Let's go.
2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. Striding in, Lazaro Armenteros. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Strike one to start the at-bat. Called strike 0-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Dodgers down in order. Striding in for the Indians, Michael Lemon. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, we used to have a saying right here, you would stride to the plate for this AB trying to chop wood. Not in today's game. You just want to get your bat plane on the same path of the ball.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. Looking for the strikeout, here's the 0-2 pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. First pitch coming, here it is. Drew Jackson is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one. Fouled away. And he struck him out.
Well, you could tell by their approach that they're going to go up there and try to be aggressive off this guy, but he's taking full advantage of that. He's pounding the zone with strikes, and right now we're seeing a lot of swings and misses and a lot of strikeouts and no walks either.
I go. Guerrero is over, and he tucks it away for the second out. Cody Hosey will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 50, Cody.
And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway. Hosey, a native of Indiana, the Hoosier State. He was a first-round pick back in the draft of 2019.
Yeah, Maddie, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Michael Lemon.
Michael.
From the stretch. Liner toward right center. That's in there. Base hit.
I'll make the turn, pick up the ball.
One run is scored. The relay, and they've got the runner hung up between first and second. And try as he might, but he can't escape the tag there, and the inning is over. So they now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Jeremy Peña. And at this point of the game, I think it's clear that the plan of attack against the top of the order has worked.
Well, when you've only surrendered one hit to the top three guys in the order up to this point in the game, you know you're doing something right, Matt.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. Climbs the wall, and he made the catch. What a play to bring it down back from the deepest part of the yard.
That was a pretty spectacular catch right there. A lot of guys mistimed that jump because they're worried about the wall coming on, but he got it just right and hauled it in. Great stuff.
He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
The left fielder.
Left side, but well foul.
Aves.
Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of his spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful.
fouled off. Two runs, three hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. And another foul ball. And it's fouled away.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
I got the count.
Well outside the strike zone as the knuckleball got away from him a bit.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Wow, this guy's mowing right through this lineup right now. But that's what happens when you don't get a chance to see a pitcher very often. That's one of the things that are helpful when you're pitching in interleague games. It's always a good advantage for the pitcher because the hitters don't get to see that guy very often.
Cody Bellinger is in for the third time as he swings and misses at that one. It's nothing and one. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. And this one will bounce into the wall.
No runner, no runner. Hold it right there.
And he is in the second with a two-out double.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off.
The tag's there, and he's out trying to steal third. Great throw. Number 15 enters from the bullpen.
Well, these guys feel pretty good about themselves, and they should. Anytime you can come into somebody else's ballpark and sweep a three-game tilt, you're doing something right. Great team effort.
13-4, the way this one ends. The Indians get their 30th win on the road so far this season. Michael Lemon earns win number 7 on the season. Ryan Weathers allowed 7 earned runs to cross the plate in the losing effort. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
A newcomer to the big leagues is interviewed about a milestone moment in his young career. player is encouraged to continue to refine a skill essential to his game. A player is entreated to keep developing the skills that are vital to his makeup.
afternoon baseball here on the show. Ought to be a good one here. Coming to the plate now, Luis Garcia. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Behind 0-2 now.
Hey, we got no one.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. Drilled to the right side. And this gets through into right, so he turns the 0-2 count into a leadoff base hit.
You don't see that too much in today's game. Most guys, it doesn't matter what the count is, they're looking to line them, drive the ball out of the ballpark. Not the case here. Good two-strike adjustment, able to punch a ground ball through a hole for a single.
Hits it high and deep out to center field. A ball that's carrying. Gorman. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Digging in the switch hitter, Dylan Carlson. As you get a look at his current righty-lefty splits entering play in this one.
Carlson.
Come on now. Get us a two ball right here.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble.
Relay, hit me, relay.
Garcia rounds third and is digging for the plate. He scores. And the deficit is down to only one now. Standing in now, Adley Rutschman. Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. So, fellas, this Indians ball club, as they begin play here this afternoon, they've been on the skids recently, losers in seven of their last nine ball games.
Yeah, guys, yesterday's loss was a tough one, a one-run loss. Hopefully they were able to just acclimate themselves to the city, get a chance to hit the streets, maybe regroup a little bit, and show up today ready to go.
Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Calhoun waits on it. Two down. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Rowdy Tellez is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Ready with the 0-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. The pitcher, Michael Lemon, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation, so let's see if that is indeed on right here. Line drive to left. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. First pitch on its way.
Leading up for the Cardinals, the second baseman, Nick Young.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Pulled toward right center field. Right fielder is on the run. And he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And that brings up outfielder Brett Phillips. One ball, no strikes to count. Here's a swing and a miss, one and one. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, one and two now.
This hitter right now looks overmatched with a fastball. I think you go right back to it.
Swing and a miss. Boy, that thing's moving pretty good. Two gone.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch, and he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
Batting it. No left fielder.
At the plate, Tyler O'Neill. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second.
Two down, two down. Here you go, guys. Let's go.
The 1-0 home. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes now. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Down in order go the Cardinals. Our score remains 2-1. Bottom of the inning now, and set to stand in is the veteran pitcher, Evan Krasinski. Back up the middle, and that is through into center, a base hit, and the opposing pitcher gets aboard to kick off the inning.
Hey, I'm not surprised right here this pitcher mixed in a knock. Playing in the National League, he gets way more opportunity to work on his craft from the offensive side of the ball. NL pitchers definitely have an advantage in these interleague games.
Yeah. Called strike two with the letters. 0-2 now.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality.
Meanwhile, now this ball's trouble as it looks like it'll be good for extra bases.
Cut it, cut it.
And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
Nolan Gorman is in for the second time now as he looks at a ball inside, 1-0. From the belt, the pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's a 3-2 ball game.
Hey, Dan, batter drives in two right there to give his team the lead. This looks like it's going to be a little bit back and forth. As a pitcher, how do you stop the bleeding?
The one thing you have to do is just concentrate all you can to try to get that first hitter out of each inning. This has the makings like this is going to be one of those seesaw affairs.
Behind 0-2 now.
Yeah.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one, make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Now batting, catcher, Adley.
Stepping in now, Adley Rutschman. And he fouls this one off. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout. Popped him up. Naylor over to his right. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So it's a runner at first with two gone, and that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. From the belt, the pitch. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Three innings complete. Cards lead it 3-2. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Nick Dunn. He's set, and the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1. Fouled away. Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes.
Stone cold take right there. That fastball very well could have sent him packing back to the bench.
Nope. To two balls and two strikes now. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
From 0-2 to 3-2, what a great at-bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
So it was a swinging strike three.
Hebro.
Nick Dunn becomes the first out in the bottom of the fourth inning.
All right.
Now Brett Phillips will bat next. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Hey, we got one down here, one down. Plays it first now.
Fouled off. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Struck him out. So he set down on strikes for the second time today.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two strike approach either.
So now to the plate, Tyler O'Neill, and it's fouled away. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. O'Neill is just shy of 6 feet at 5'11", a right-handed batter and thrower. He's an 11-year vet at the major league level, so he certainly puts together a nice career in professional baseball.
Yeah, Matty, this guy has had an amazing.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and new inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Michael Lemon. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Couldn't help himself that time as he chases one below the knees. It's strike one.
Oh, man, was that a hack. He's trying to create his own run support with a swing like that.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, watch out. This hitter's got one thing on his mind.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
Man, the pitcher let the guy off easy right there. That 0-2 pitch wasn't even close. I'd rate that as a non-competitive pitch.
And he popped him up.
Done.
Onto the grass. He's there and records the first down.
Into the box now, Evan Krasinski. He reached on a single in his first try.
Yeah, he showed like a little prowess with the bat right there, Dan. I'd be surprised if they don't attack him a little bit more carefully this AB.
0-1, here's the pitch. Knuckleball, 1-1. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Rogers scoops it up, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. He's set. Here it comes. High in the air, deep down the left field line. A ball that's carrying. And he makes the catch in the corner. Digging in to try it again, Nolan Gorman. He singled and drove home two his last time. Ball one to start the at-bat. Right side, but it's well foul.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
1-2 now. This is pulled into right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away. And bottom of the sixth inning now. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Dylan Carlson.
The right fielder, Gillis. Carlson.
First pitch of the at bat on its way.
He said that yesterday too.
Here we go, guys.
I sent him a text saying, "Can you come out and play?"
The 1-0 is in there for strike one.
I got a ball, one strike.
No contact there, and it's 1-2. And he rings up another one. Make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game. First offering on its way. Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line in left. And that'll get down for a base hit.
No runner, no runner.
And he'll pull into second with one away. So a good job of going the other way here as he checks in with the one out double. And as you can see on our team leaders graphic, that gives him now 30 on the year. Fouled away. 3-2 is our score here in inning number 6. Down and in as he's forced to back out of the way that time. Lays off the knuckleball and it's 2-1.
One out here, we got one.
All even now, 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. Standing in, Nick Dunn. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Oh, my, this ball is crushed.
He got that.
Where will this one end up?
He did.
And that one is gone.
There are certain guys in every lineup that you do not want to beat you. And this guy right now is swinging the bat so well, I'm not giving him a chance to do anything. He's too hot right now.
Now here comes the Cleveland skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. 5 2/3 innings of work on his final ledger as he was not particularly sharp from the get-go here. Felipe Cortez.
He said after show probably about 6 minutes.
His 15th appearance of the year.
Felipe Cortez.
Set, but listen, it's still a sweep. Hey, man, winners make the rules around here, and they earned it.
5-2, the final today. The Redbirds led this game from the third inning on and never wavered.
Evan Krasinski earns win number 7 on the season. Number 73 closes the door for the save, his 26th. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Afternoon. First for the victorious St. Louis Cardinals, 5 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base. For Cleveland, 2 runs, 6 hits. No errors. They left 15 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 3 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
A skipper appeals to his players to demonstrate some resilience in how they finish a rough season.
God. What's up?
What's up, homie?
Same old, same old. Well, went to my heart doctor today.
And
I got to go back on the 16th and do a swab test for the COVID. They go draw more blood, and then they want to do a procedure. They want to run a microscope through my vein.
Yippers.
And take pictures of the heart and everything. Yep, and they're going to go through the veins to do it. They better.
They will. They will. All you have to do is ask me. I would have told you. They do. They did it to me when I had mine, and when I thought I had a heart attack in Detroit a couple years back. You remember that?
Yeah. So he said I can come in anytime on the 16th between 8 and 4 and they can do all that, and then I got to go back on the 26th. The hospital's going to call to set me up so I can go in there and get that all done.
Well, at least you're getting it done.
Oh, yeah. All right, one thing is another.
Yeah, you know that's right. Or you should actually say it like Dennis does. Oh, you know that's right.
One good thing about the rookie mode. Okay, I can beat this up. Good deal.
But as you were?
You got all the bites you really need. Yep. You just got to modify them a little bit, that's all. You go ahead, big boy. Yep. So Kelly bought me a vape today. So sweet of her.
Very nice of her.
Yeah, 75-35, buddy. Nice vape.
Send me a picture.
Send you a picture of it?
Send me a picture. Because you must have one of them big boys.
Mm-hmm. It's 100 watt.
Oh, yeah. You're going to be inhaling and going... blah, 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 blah.
I got it set real low. Real low.
Let me guess. Two? Two and a half?
Three. Three milligrams of tobacco. MLB the show.
Stepping in, Cole Tucker. He'll lead things off here in the bottom.